All right, back again. This is Ben,
Kevin,
and Patrick.
We're playing Steven against John C. Steven is running Dengar, which does the thing where if you're in you're in his firing arc and you do an attack against him, then he gets to attack back. So double tap once per turn. Yeah, I had someone cheat on me and did it with each attack, which is not good.
Yes, Ben had this. Someone did this multiple times at the Denver Regionals.
So, and I was new to the game and I didn't know. No. Oh. Veteran's Instinct, which gives him two extra.
Makes him 11.
A pilot skill 11, which is crazy quick. Then we've got K4, which says if you execute a green maneuver, you get a target lock on him, which is pretty powerful. Punishing one, you add one attack dice, so you can see he's three instead of two.
Most expensive upgrade card in the game.
Really?
12 points.
Damn.
Right?
Really?
Yes. It's absolutely worth it, but it's 12 points.
That's crazy.
Okay. How you like Miranda?
What?
That says Miranda.
Oh, he's modded the hell out of it.
He mods most of his
It's a
things.
K-Wing. It's the K-Wing wings.
Uh-huh.
On a Mist Hunter body.
Boy.
That's a serious ship right there.
Yeah.
All right, so he's a Jakku Gunrunner, and his... What is Jakku? Is that that's just
that's
is that
one of the
basics?
Okay. One of the two basics.
He has running it with Gunner, so if he gets no hits, he gets to reroll and do another attack. Cloaking device, which gives him +2 on his defense, or is a so he should be at right. He should is two natural, or he should be at four.
That's two natural when he is cloaked.
He gets okay.
Two extra.
If he's got the cloak token, he gets an extra two.
But then at the end of the round, you roll, and if you get an eyeball, then
it goes away. You still get a proper decloak though.
Okay, even if it goes away. Okay, what's the other one? Space.
Space tug tractor assembly. Or
tractor
array.
Okay, so anyone friendly or enemy ship within range one, you can assign a tractor beam token, which
it
is force them. If it's a small based ship, you can force them to do a barrel roll.
You do a barrel roll or boost with their ship.
Okay. When does that happen? When you do the
action.
They get a choose.
And yes, you can barrel roll them onto an asteroid with a tractor beam token.
Okay. They get to choose the direction for front or back. I think you get to choose whether it's left or right.
Nope. With tractor beam, it's the person using the tractor beam chooses the whole maneuver.
Okay, but for large base ships, it just works like an ion token, right?
Yeah, no, it reduces agility dice by one.
Oh, reduces agility. Does it do it with small base ships too? And you get to move them. Okay. Let's see. Syndicate Thug, just another basic one. Vector Thrusters, which...
lets him do a
barrel roll. Okay. Unhinged Astromech, all three movement...
Are green.
And Twin Laser Turret, which you get to range two or three. You can do two attacks with four attack dice or
three?
Three attack dice. So... there we go. All right, and then John C. with all the mods,
has
he's got
all of the freaking mods.
It has a lot of stuff. So I think in the sake of time
he's
here,
got 16 cards on there.
Yeah, that's ridiculous. We're gonna let you guys figure that out because otherwise we'll just be sitting here talking and through his what his cards are, and someone's gonna die.
So I'm just gonna go over this really briefly. Ahsoka Tano is built as a bomb dropper in this list. The idea is she has captured Ty, which keeps her from getting shot at, but she can still drop bombs and do stuff that way without actually firing a shot.
Well, and Dengar can still shoot on him because his pilot skill is higher than
her. Dengar could take a shot at her.
Yeah, so that's I would go if I were playing against John C., I'd take Dengar after her because she's only got three, right? Three hits and she's done.
Yeah.
She does have three defense dice, but still.
Yep. Miranda has shield regening capability. She's also got a bomb loadout and advanced slam, so she can drop her bombs after she does her slam.
Okay.
At least, I think the counternet she can. I don't think she can with the thermal detonator.
She can't. Well, the thermal detonator she has to drop before she does anything else.
Okay. Or she moves, yeah.
Well,
yeah.
She can do before her boost, she reveals it out. If they have like the advanced ailerons or something like that that allows you to move before you reveal.
He is. Oh, he just missed it. Steve just brought in his quad jumper. Didn't quite get a barrel roll, or didn't quite get the
range.
The tractor beam.
Tractor beam. Yeah.
The tractor beam token on Miranda.
Because, like, thermal detonators have to be placed when you reveal your die, your yes. dial.
I would go after Ahsoka, but he's only got one that can, so.
And yeah. So the other interesting thing is he's using the U-Wing as a bumper in this list, and he's got a bunch of cards to support that.
Oh, you're talking John C's, yeah. Yes. So to run into people?
To run into people and allow him to still operate when he runs into people. Okay. That's the idea behind Zeb and Chopper, is when he runs into you, he can actually still be able to roll attacks and stuff on you.
But Zeb kind of, unless you bump him in the rear, kind of nullifies the bump for both parties.
Well, the other party loses their actions, which quite frankly is the reason, 9 times out of 10, the reason that you're doing the bump is you've got someone like Sundir failed or one of the defenders that you're looking to try to stop them from getting their defense tokens. And by bumping them, you stop them from taking actions. Mm-hmm. So even if Zeb lets them shoot, well, Hef gets to shoot as well. So.
Ooh, he's going to hit him.
Oh, yeah, he is. That's not the ship he wants to be hitting.
No,
with.
Miranda.
No.
Yeah, he hit, cause I think.
No. He completed the maneuver.
That's crazy. Once again, we got to use the plain black background, Matt, for this.
I think this one's better than the other one.
It is better than the other one, but still, plain black. So let's see, who's left to run? Dengar still
Dengar
needs to
be? And Tino.
Ahsoka,
yeah.
So what did he take for his action for Miranda?
I'm not sure.
That is a wonderful question.
Yeah. Actually, no, I think he did bump. Oh, no.
No, he's slamming.
He's slamming, yeah.
By the way, Jeff is an extremely experienced Imperial player.
You mean John?
John. Yes, John. Jeff is very Rebels, but
yeah.
John is absolutely an experienced Imperial player, and this is way outside his
norm.
Comfort zone.
Yeah.
That's a focus token. And he did actually use the weapons disable token.
Oh. Yeah, he does like to use his tokens.
Yep.
Because the slam disables your weapons, advanced slam.
Yep. Well, slam disables your weapons.
So he's doing that to get behind everybody, it looks like, right? Because
yeah.
Now everybody else is out of arc and misplaced. They're going to spend another turn.
I honestly think he should have done a two-speed and then done a hard two-slam or a two-bank to try to be able to be in a position to drop his counternet.
Yeah. Well, you're not going to go against the against Hef with his pilot skill of 1 and 2. Plus, Hef is going to bump, so that's kind of weird.
He's really holding Ahsoka back, and I don't understand why. Do you have any idea on that?
I don't know. Well, maybe he's afraid of Dengar. So,
I mean,
but if you can
understand getting her over on the other side where they can't shoot at her yet, but.
Oh, trying to sweep it around so you're not in Dengar's...
Yeah, not in Dengar's direct path.
What?
Well, Dengar's got a 360.
Yeah.
It does have a turret on it.
But still, if he's trying to get her down toward towards the bottom of the map, she might be trying. He might be trying to get her out of the out of his direct range for a little bit. Not necessarily out of his arc.
Syndicate Thug still has he has TLTs, so he should. He still has got a shot on Miranda here, right?
Yep. Yeah. And I think Miranda will return fire, but I don't know. I don't know. He might want to try to get that quad jumper off the board before it.
I don't know.
Throws some monkey wrenches.
Miranda's pointing the wrong way, though.
She's got 360.
She's got 360.
I know, but I thought it was if it was an arc. The front arc is only the time you can return fire. I didn't think it was
Dengar.
For
which
Dengar.
Is the top
one. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Miranda's abilities don't matter about arcs. Dengar's absolutely does.
Oh. Okay, so he's doing twin laser turrets. He got all blanks. So second roll for TLTs, I think.
No, because that would have been Dengar.
It would have to be Dengar
to
shot.
Oh, so Dengar shot at Hef then, probably, right? So that's the only thing that's in range.
No, he's got a 360, so he could shoot Miranda, I think.
Oh, okay.
And he did, well, yeah, it's either Miranda or Hef, because he rolled two.
Well, it was Miranda. Yeah, he measured range from Miranda to Dengar.
He measured range for both.
Two.
Whee!
Someone bumped the camera there.
It gets hit every week, I think.
You need to invest in a center block to keep that thing still.
Well, either that or put some tape. Rope. Yeah. I'll just bring some masking tape and we'll masking tape so people don't walk through it.
Yeah. I was thinking about putting a weight on the tripod too.
Ooh. Is he winning an arc? Oh, he's got I wants me a blue laser. No.
No. Oh.
Out of arc.
Dang it. Quad jumper. No.
If you hadn't barrel rolled. But
he was trying to barrel roll to get one of Miranda, but just didn't pull it off. That's rough.
Well, so far we've just got Miranda's got one hit.
That's
one TLT hit. So.
Well no, Miranda sacrificed.
A shield?
To try to get an extra attack die to get something into Dengar.
Yeah.
Didn't succeed, unfortunately.
Well, let's see. They're back to dials.
Yeah, they're at long range. They're still early engagement.
Yeah. I'd definitely try to get Dengar over to Ahsoka, but we'll see.
Yeah.
Then you run the risk of bumping the other one. I think that's why he's keeping Ahsoka over there.
It could be a tactic.
Because if you get close enough, then bump can happen.
I think he's trying to engage someone other than... I don't know. I think you need to get in there and fly past them and put some bombs in front of them and then go on by.
Yep.
Drop some stuff. Drop some shenanigans. Hopefully he takes himself out.
Well, I mean, you get in there behind them, then you take some shots, try to kill someone, get your bombs back, do it again. And you kind of use it as a Sabine hauler.
Oh, okay. Salvage crane, yeah.
But you're going to need to do some work with the bombs off the K-Wing.
And what's also interesting, I was just thinking about, with having the tractor beam, that's not an attack. So he could tractor beam Ahsoka still.
He can.
Tractor beam's in action.
So that's what I would go for instead of Miranda here. Tractor beam him, move him.
Drop Ahsoka on a rock or something?
Yeah. That would be funny.
That's what I would try to do.
TIE fighters have a good dial. It's kind of hard to catch them.
I do. Well, unless you have four people firing at you.
Oh,
like yesterday.
Yeah.
Yesterday we were playing Mario Kart, and I was out front with Sabine, and I got my butt kicked.
Yeah.
Because everybody was... Pew, pew, pew!
Yeah, Sabine was having a bad day.
Yeah. I was one of the guys that everyone was pissed off about because I had a Y-Wing with
Ion
turret.
Ion turret and a Y-Wing.
It was fun and interesting.
really good.
Tokyo drifting. The Ion tokens.
Yep.
Oh, God. We just need to catch that fucking K-Wing with those Ion turrets and stop them.
All right.
Yeah. They're hard to take out, though.
Let's see what happens here. So first we've got Jakku, Gunrunner. What is he doing? A hard one?
Hard? Why? Does he think the U-Wing's going to come into it?
Is
no?
he cloaking? Oh, is he target locking?
He had a target lock.
On who?
Wait, oh. No,
I can't
that
tell.
Was from the Y-Wing.
Okay.
He put a focus on
the Y-Wing target locked him earlier.
Well, that's an interesting choice for Syndicate Thug. Well, I guess because of TLT, it doesn't matter. He just needs to keep
it's
within range 2 of something.
More strategic about it.
Strategery?
Yes. Yes. The Y-Wing needs to move strategery.
Yeah. The Y-Wing.
Well, that is a good
really
move.
He should really have Cavil in it. Cavil in the Y-Wing.
Well, there's no way he would be able to fit Dengar on this list with that.
Well, I don't know if punishing one is really worth it, but, well, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
12, though.
12! Oh, yeah.
What punishing one, what does that one come in?
It comes in the punish. A punishing one pack. It's part of the same pack you get the Jumpmaster out of.
Oh, okay. 12, though. Jeez.
Yeah.
One extra attack die is a lot of. Going from 2 to 3 is a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's true. Oh, he's slamming. Why is he slamming?
That's a wonderful question. Does he want to get some munition? I don't know what he's.
Oh, he's. I think he may be trying to do thermal detonators on his next turn, or something like that. I don't know what to say. And he is using Ahsoka as bait, I think, because once again, in formation with the U-Wing.
Either that or just having the U-Wing be protection. Hopefully.
That's a green maneuver, by the way.
That's a green maneuver for Dengar? A one hard is?
To the left.
Oh, to the left. That's right. I forgot.
One hard and two hard to the left are greens. Yeah. It's such an awkward trip to fly.
Things to the left are green. Things to the right are
white.
Oh,
white.
Yeah.
What?
Target lock that mofo. Yep. There we go.
Oh, that's not good. Oh, Miranda may be getting some pain right there.
Yeah. It's interesting that he's targeting Miranda. Well, I guess she only has one defense dice, so...
Yeah.
Right.
Well, no, I'm wondering why Miranda would be targeting Locke. Does she really want to trigger that second attack? She's in his arc.
Yeah.
She'll get the second attack on her.
No, but Miranda's facing the wrong way. Miranda didn't target
Miranda's her. got her turrets.
Yeah. Oh, okay, she has TLTs. But she's not in range 2.
Her
though.
Natural turret's also 360.
Oh.
Yeah, she's got built-in TLT without the without the twin part.
No, it's range 1 to 3. Her normal weapon.
Yeah.
And range 1, she gets 3 dice on it, so. Still fairly effective.
Dengar range 1 will have 4 dice. Ouch.
Yep. And he'll get to roll them twice.
Why?
If he shoots at Miranda, or if Miranda shoots at him. He'll get a second shot on him.
But what didn't he roll for Dengar yet? I don't understand.
He just got a hit. I think Dengar's shot.
That. Okay. No, this is Dengar's shot. What is he doing?
Dengar would have been the first one to shoot.
Yeah.
Did we miss it?
I think Dengar fired Then Dengar returned fire on Miranda after Miranda shot.
Okay. Ouch, Miranda's
and
hurt.
And Ahsoka's not been shooting, so...
Of course not. It's kind of weird.
Realistically, I think the play with Ahsoka with that captured TIE card is to shove her into the enemy's face and get some bombs in there. Because they're not going to be able to shoot at you anyway right off the bat. Dengar being PS'd up to 11, that's kind of a...
Unusual.
It is. It's really unusual.
His 9's pretty high. I would have kept it, but then...
Miranda's up at... Ahsoka's up at
92.
He's
a VI.
Yeah.
VI is almost an auto-include on Ahsoka, though.
Ooh, what's going to happen here? Ah, I have a feeling that Miranda's going to drop that bomb.
Well, shit, is this thermodetonator?
No, I'm just tired.
You're yawning at us. Jeez, Ben.
I'm tired.
By the way,
I need some coffee.
This is a completely new list for John, so
yeah.
It's not an expert playthrough for him.
Definitely not.
You notice all the damage on the board is on John's side.
Yep.
Well, I would drop the thermal detonator if I were Miranda, right?
I would have.
Because you've got two ships, enemy ships in range one right now, and no friendly ships in range one.
Oh
no,
yeah.
Do you think the Y-wing's in range one?
Yeah.
Y-wing's not in range one.
These are both range one.
But. No. The only one
Miranda.
That might...
It's going to be a one template behind it.
The only one that
I thought
might...
it was 360. Okay.
For the detonator, it's going to be a one sitting
The only thing
it.
That might be in range one, if he drops the thermal detonator now...
Most likely
might
Dengar.
Be punished. Yeah, Dengar.
Yeah, Dengar would probably get hit by the thermal detonator.
Yeah, but the Y-Wing would be gone, the Quadjumper would be gone, and Miranda would be gone.
Taking
because
a
she'd have to boost at minimum two or three to get out of there.
I'll be honest, I'm not 100% sure I would have turned in with Dengar like that, because not having any left turns that are green, it makes it difficult. If this actually would be probably an amazingly good time for him to drop those thermal detonators, is if he put stress on Dengar, Dengar's not going to be able to keep his arc in the fight.
He just backed up?
He did. He backed up.
Which is stress.
I don't know. Why? Why do you think he was... What do you think he's thinking?
I think he thinks Miranda's going to come, and he wants to... Miranda's going to come.
Around.
You think Miranda's going to swing in there?
Yeah, I think so. So.
And he's bringing the Y-Wing over there. Do you think
that's really weird. Has he cloaked yet? He hasn't cloaked.
I think he actually had it break on the first turn.
Oh, did he? Okay.
If I remember correctly.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Very.
Okay, he's in... What's the thing with... If he's within range one, you can spend a focus on...
He can... He can
Which
use an action to do the target, to do the... Holy crap, he brought half right up in there.
So he's probably...
Well, he's trying to bump.
Yeah.
He's probably not going to drop a thermal detonator because it would definitely hit half.
Yeah, that's kind of an awkward play. I don't know if I'd want so many bombs and a blocker in this list. That seems challenging.
He's dropping the
thermal.
Oh,
he is. So it's anything within range one of the thermal?
Yeah.
Bombs
when does it,
do not
when does it activate?
After the last person takes their action phase.
The start of combat phase, I think.
No, end of action phase.
That's a really small distinction, but it's almost the same point in time.
But there is a distinct point between the end of the action phase and the start of combat phase.
Oh, look at that flying. Good job.
That
I
is
see some bombs
oh,
happening.
Oh, shit. He hit the asteroid.
And he hit the asteroid, which means
he lost
he
his action.
No actions.
So he can't drop his bomb.
Yeah.
And because he tapped the asteroid.
He took damage. He scraped that asteroid with his...
He already had one shield gone.
No,
that's
Ahsoka.
A hole on Ahsoka.
Oh, on Ahsoka. Ooh, jeez, that's bad.
Right?
Yeah.
I thought he'd missed it. Oh, well.
Yeah.
No, he didn't. He put his template down, and it was moving that
asteroid.
That's
a really shitty place for Ahsoka to be.
All right. Oh, yeah. What is Dengar doing? Let's see. Move.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, it's a left-hand turn. To the left.
Yeah, this is why I don't think I would have snapped
Dengar's
a one hard
to take
there.
Shield.
Because he's going to have to swing out of the fight. Well.
Oh, he reversed.
He slooped.
Oh, that's good. Is that
a left-hand sloop? That's a white maneuver.
It's a white maneuver for him? Wow.
To the
left.
Wow. To the left his sloop.
So that's
away.
How you turn around. Okay.
Yep.
So he's taking the damage, but it's going to be on the shields.
It is.
Okay. Action. What was his action?
He focused.
He's got a target lock on somebody.
Oh.
Who does he have?
Oh, so
it's hard to tell.
That's over here on Miranda.
Okay. All right, number 11. Oh,
yeah.
No, there he goes.
There's his focus.
Focus.
Okay.
All right.
So
now
combat, it explodes. Boom.
Goes off. Stress.
So you get a damage and a stress.
Damage on each, yep.
Half as well.
Anything
within
range one.
It hasn't caught up though, I guess. I'm just saying you're slow.
It's Danielle.
Taking the Danielle's doing it. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Well, no, she's fast. I mean, she's fast. There we go. Okay. Let the red dice begin.
Do
you think he's gonna?
I would take on Ahsoka with Dengar.
I would hit Miranda because she's halfway down.
Miranda's also got shield regen.
Yeah.
So you want to get her off the table quickly.
But did she do her sloop this turn?
Miranda?
Not sloop. Slam.
No.
Okay. Well, she can fire then.
Miranda's just out of range too, it looks like.
That's
and
not good.
Ahsoka's range 3 through a rock.
So, what is he doing?
Hopefully he's going after Miranda.
Oh, gosh. He's going to spend the target lock on Miranda.
Yep.
And 3 hits.
Oh!
1 evade.
That white freaking dice is impossible to read.
Yeah.
You just put 3 cards. Oh, no, 2 cards.
Damn, oh, Miranda's
Lord.
Down to 2.
Yeah.
Is it in range of the syndicate thug?
But you also got to remember. So one thing that you need to think about is if you see Miranda on the board, you think about it the same way you think of an Omega Leader. You kill it quick.
Uh-huh.
Because that thing is not something you want to deal with in a one-on-one at the end of the game.
Miranda, well, no.
All right,
Ahsoka's
so now
going after the
Ahsoka's, she's going to fire? Wow.
That was a mistake.
Yeah. Why is she doing 3?
She's at range 1.
Miranda.
Oh.
She's shooting at the syndicate thug.
Okay.
Yeah. The
no.
What?
No, that was half on.
Oh, half. Yeah.
It was half shooting on the Dengar.
Why did he?
But
lose,
Dengar gets to
damage.
Fire back, right?
Yeah. Should.
This is correct though.
Yeah.
So Miranda did recover a shield.
All right, so Dengar is confusing. How did that?
Yeah, this one, like, how did he lose a hull?
She didn't.
Danielle messed up when she was doing the damage. Now it's
accurate.
Now in my list, that actually will happen. Because I've run it with Children Gen.
Yeah.
Okay, so what IGA. What happened? Now the Syndicate Thug range 2 Miranda for 3 dice. Twice. So he might be able to almost take care of her.
That's 1.
She's got 3 health right now.
Yeah.
She's got 2. Oh, yeah.
3. She regened a shield.
And took the focus. So
I can't tell if she hit or not.
He should have hit twice.
Miranda running around with 1 hole left.
Yeah. That's what it should be.
I think we just saw something go off of Hef, which is weird. Did he not get any shots? Really? Okay, he's going to do Jakku Gunner, and he's got Gunner on that one, so yeah, hit Miranda. Let's see. What's he doing? Yeah. Gunner. 1 hit. Got it. 1 off. Cut the shield.
Got the shield.
So the other, the twin laser turret didn't hit last time then.
Apparently.
Oh, that's rough.
Yeah.
But wait. Did he try to... How did...
I think he targeted
Hef.
Oh, no.
Hold
Hef,
it. Hold
right?
it.
He
hold
must
it.
Have targeted Hef.
He might have been in range 1, so he might have had to shoot his normal... He might not be able to shoot.
Well, he went after
Hef.
Why
wings don't
would
have...
But the TLT is 2-3.
Yeah.
If he's within range 1 of Miranda, he wouldn't have been able to fire on
Miranda. Because Hef went down a shield, so that's probably what happened.
Yeah,
he may have had
Hef.
To shoot at Hef because he couldn't fire on Miranda.
All right.
That's quite possibly what happened.
Yeah.
There's going to be some bombage coming.
As we learned in Mario Kart yesterday about TLTs.
Yeah. It's just funny that they go from rolling 3 dice to doing 1 damage no matter what. It's weird.
Yeah, but it's a really high percentage of getting 2 hits.
Yeah.
Which is good.
The TLTs are all about consistency.
Yeah.
Not about peak damage. And they're actually fairly good against aces because it'll typically cause them to pull off some of the tokens. Because you can do up to 6 attacks with them.
Yeah, so I'm not sure what's going on here. I would,
They're setting dials.
No, I think, I don't know, maybe with Hef, try to block, I think. I would do a hard 3 to try to bump Dengar.
What would you do with a quad jumper?
I don't know.
It's got a stress on it.
Well, you've got to go forward.
You own one.
You've got to go forward and to get...
He's got a clear stress, but what would you want to be? Where would you want to put that claw jumper if you could?
I would move it 2 or 3 because he's got the tractor beam and put him in. Try to get range 1.
You
got to
remember the dial.
It has an odd dial.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would move it forward 3. I think.
Would you try to barrel roll Miranda?
Oh, I definitely try and barrel roll Miranda.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, if you can get a agility or a tractor beam token on Miranda, because the quad jumper's going to move late.
No, quad jumper moves first.
Quad jumper moves first. Slow PS.
So you can definitely.
So you can
2 forward and tractor Miranda onto the.
You can't.
Asteroid.
You can.
Would
a
1 bank get him on this one?
No, there's 1 right behind it, right? Is that a...
No.
That's not 1? Okay.
No. You can see all the asteroids.
Okay.
1, 2, 3...
It won't, but it may mess up his day, so...
Well, yeah, I mean, if you put a 1 bank there, and then you got an agility 0 Miranda.
I was saying...
Yeah, that's good, too. Wham,
range,
bam, thing. He's doing it,
range 2.
He went 2, right?
2 straight.
That's gonna put
her in arc.
Yep.
That's... And tractor her over.
Yeah. Tractor.
Well.
Tractor pull.
The real question is, if he does it well, then he's gonna guarantee that. Yeah, he's tractoring her.
When does the tractor fire?
Right away.
Immediately.
Then why? Oh, he's putting the token there. There's to make it minus one agility. Okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
No.
Oh, yep.
He
hit it? Yeah, he put him on the asteroid.
Is he thinking? He doesn't have a whole lot of.
Oh, can he not put him on the asteroid?
Yes, he can.
Okay. Yeah. Then why did he not do that?
I don't know. Maybe he's thinking about where a bomb would land if Miranda dropped one. But I think one bank would make more sense there.
It would. It would mess up his day.
Actually, now that I think about that, if I could have barrel rolled him away, I'd have barrel rolled Miranda away. Just in case you wanted to
drop
him.
So it's a boost or a barrel roll for the tractor beam? Okay.
And it doesn't.
Why didn't he? I would have put him right in front of the asteroid.
Well, I think he's more concerned about what would happen if he dropped a bomb.
Oh.
Because I don't think he could get him on the asteroid. And he may be thinking about what he was going to do with the Syndicate thug there.
What's he going to do with the thug?
But that, because if he had boosted him on the asteroid, would that have made it more likely that it would end up in range one of the thug?
Well, he would have been on, he would have been on the asteroid, so he'd immediately take a roll. And then if he'd have done his movement, he'd have to do it again.
Oh, God.
So I don't understand why he did it.
That might have took Miranda out
right
there.
That might have taken Rand out, yeah.
Well, it could have.
But still, that's what I would have done. Cause, but
Heffa's gonna get in there. And
yeah, we like we thought.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Bringing Heff in for the bump. This might get Dengar.
Bump. Now, because of the way Heff is set up, he actually has two agility, not one.
Oh yeah.
But it's the program's not set up to do that because it's flipping the card over. So
yeah.
Well, he's got to go forward because left is going to be bad for Dengar. Dengar. I'd do three forward if I were Dengar. Oh, we got Miranda first.
He's dropping. What?
Oh, it is okay. Within range one, but it's going to hit. It's going to hit.
How'd he...
Well, she hasn't moved.
Oh, that's
how'd
true.
How'd he get the second... thermal detonator.
She's got
extra
munitions. So that's...
Okay.
Why didn't he do the curve? That doesn't make sense at all.
Don't know.
That's weird. Okay.
No, remember, he was planning on being about one straight back from there.
Well, at least Syndicate Thug's TLTs are still in range. He's in three.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, he's going to drop another bomb.
He's trying to take out the...
get the
gun runner. But I don't think he's going to... It's not going to work, but...
Yeah, that quad jumper's got a bad day.
Yeah, cluster mine.
I think he's got two cluster mines on him of his three. Leaves one on the board.
Yeah.
Great.
So what is it? Do you roll for damage?
He's gonna roll four dice.
Yeah, and that's how it's supposed to be. The guy who gets hit rolls the dice,
which is pertinent if you got Palpatine.
Yeah,
because you can palp those dice to blanks.
Yeah. Palp one.
You can palp one to a blank.
Yeah.
Oh gosh. So what? I didn't see. Did he get any?
I don't know. I'll have to see.
Well, he would be stupidly lucky if he got away with nothing.
Jeez. Okay. Yeah, that quad.
Wow, that quad jumper's lucky.
Yeah.
Wow.
He's going to take one from the...
And he can't move.
That quad jumper has taken a lot of explosions near it. Unlike the one that survived it, or didn't survive in the movie.
Doesn't Dengar, since he ran into him, didn't he get a The damage, right?
No.
Yeah. Against Hef?
Yeah, he did take one. Oh. Okay.
Cool. Oh, Lord. Hang on here. He took three?
He took two three. From the... Yeah.
One from the first, two from the second.
Okay, so we're just behind. Oh, they're... Ooh. One another for some reason. Yeah.
Damn.
That quad jumper's having a bad day.
Well, that's because of the...
He took...
The other ball.
Yeah.
He took three from the cluster mines and one from the thermal detonator.
That could have taken him out.
Yeah.
And he's stressed.
That's a lot of ordnance on a little guy.
Yeah.
All right, so...
There's a quad jumper.
Okay, so Ahsoka's going to
really
fire.
Interesting shenanigans.
Ahsoka's going to fire? Is that range one against the gunrunner's probably gone. Oh, Dengar should be firing, yep.
No, Ahsoka's facing the wrong way.
Oh, no, Dengar doesn't have a shot. Because he didn't have a shot.
Wait, no, I heard...
Miranda took her down.
Yeah, I caught up on at the end of this. Our end of this round, he forgot about Hef right here, and just after they set their dials, they retconned that because he forgot he had Hef, and they fire at the end.
Oh.
What fires at the end?
They redo Hef and Dengar.
Okay.
They redo the attack because he forgot about Hef's ability.
How Hef's ability actually works. Ooh, is Miranda going to die this turn?
We'll see. Possibly. TLT.
She got one on him.
She might die next turn.
Oh, man. Well, Dengar...
Well, the big thing, Dengar gets to fire back if Hef actually fires on him, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, ba-bam. Yep. That's what's gonna happen. See, I wouldn't have done one forward. I would have done three forward. Because I mean,
two.
You knew that
on Dengar.
On yeah, Dengar, because you knew he was coming for you to bump, or at least I did.
Yeah, he did two forward, not three.
Yeah,
if he would have done three forward, that would have Miranda would have been gone.
Yeah, Miranda or a three bank.
Well, that would have been to the left. That would have been green.
Yeah. Three speeds aren't green. He didn't have stress, so a 30 bank would have been fine.
Yeah.
Two bank would be green.
Okay, so.
Huh.
What are they? Are they waiting for dials?
They're doing dials right now. Ooh. What would you do if you were Miranda?
It's a horrible situation because
it's a horrible situation.
It is. If you go after Syndicate Thug, then there's nothing to do. I'd disengage.
Yeah. I mean, would you try to disengage and fly off? Or well,
I would fly, fly to the right and drop a Connor net. At least get some of my ordnance off before I die.
Yeah.
Right?
Just get it on the table?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because with only one left, there's no reason. Even though there isn't anything in range.
He hasn't dropped either one of his Connor nets
no,
yet.
No.
Here's
he can
redoing,
do.
He
can redo
Dengar and Hef.
So this is Dengar's second attack.
This is Dengar's first attack.
Because of the touching, they can both.
Oh.
They're considered not touching.
This is the way Zeb works. Okay.
Three hits, one.
Oh, he's gone.
Hef goes.
Oh.
The bumper goes away.
Yeah, would you?
That makes a big difference for dials.
Would you?
Hey, kitty.
What would you do? Would you fly Zeph? Zeb? Do you think he's worthwhile? I mean, he's going to give you a shot.
If he wasn't rebel
I don't
only.
No.
If he wasn't rebel only, I'd put him on the, I want to say the decimator that you bump, you.
On
Oikids? Takes damage.
Damage and then shoot. Yeah, that would make it worth it.
but unfortunately, Zeb's rebel only.
Well, there's probably a reason for that.
Yeah.
Because you don't want him on Oinkins, yeah. Because that's ridiculous.
That's, yeah.
Bumper car. Captain Crunch.
Meow, meow. Rechopper crew on the ghost. Seriously.
Okay, so dials. Well, it makes it pretty easy what Dengar does, so...
Yeah, Dengar doesn't have a whole lot of missed choices.
Just go forward as fast as you can, and hopefully you can catch Miranda before Carnernet gets dropped. I would drop a damn Carnernet. I mean, with only one hull left on Miranda, you got to get something off, you know?
Just put the Carnernet on the board, yeah. Just because...
Especially if you do, like, a hard one or two, drop it behind you. It'll at least keep the Syndicate thug at arm's length. Well, even though you don't want him on arm's length, but yet it still provided him problems.
I mean, he took down the one ship that Steve has to worry about an arc on.
Yeah, that's true.
Steve has 2 360s now.
Yeah.
John C's got a 360 on life support.
Yep, C.
He's bringing
Carnernet. I would do a Carnernet.
Well, Carnernet's that would come out behind, so I wouldn't.
Yeah, but does it happen? Carnernet happens after you move, though,
yes.
Right?
So it'd be, yeah.
So I would do a hard two and drop the Carnernet. Bam. Just to do something.
Hey, he's barrel rolling his Y-wing. Surprised that thing didn't fly apart.
Yeah, Y-wings are not that stable.
Oh my gosh, what?
No, that is really smart.
Is he trying to be inside of the...
Inside the arc.
TLTs.
Inside the TLT.
Okay. It's also going to be more challenging for Dengar to get in there.
Ooh, look at that.
And here's a bump.
So this is a dead turn for Steve.
Yeah, he successfully blocked TLT.
And Miranda can go ahead and roll two dice for her.
On Dengar, why did he only do a two? Is a three bad?
It's white. Did he have a stress?
No.
I don't understand that.
Yeah, I don't either.
I think he might be trying to suck him in a little bit. Suck him into the middle of the board. Or he's trying to avoid being around where that other cluster mine is.
No, but still, going three forward would have put you more into the fight. I don't understand why he didn't do three. That's very strange.
I mean, unless he had a stress on there and we didn't notice it.
Yeah.
Because a three's white for a jump master.
Well, yeah.
All his three maneuvers are white.
Yep. Oh, well. What did K4 do? I forgot.
She picked up a shield. Green maneuvers, you get a target lock. But, you know, at this point...
Maybe that's what he was trying to do with the two green to get a target lock on somebody. That's probably what was happening.
How did it... Well, two bank would have probably been better.
So, Miranda's not an arc, and
Miranda's
ran
in
range one. Yeah.
Miranda got...
Syndicate.
Took a shot minus a dice, so she took a two dice shot. And she got one damage on the Syndicate.
All right, dials.
So Miranda's running around with a shield and a hull.
Those Y-Wing... The Y-Wing and K-Wing are about the same for how much damage they can take.
The K-Wing's... Well...
K-Wing has one more shield. That's it.
K-Wing does have another shield.
That is the only difference.
Because I think he's probably going to do two forward on Dengar just to try to get the target lock again, but who knows?
I'd do a two bank.
Yeah.
I would too, yeah. Because it's green.
Yeah.
And then
is it green? Is this two bank? And the two hard? Green. Oh, maybe a two hard even.
Well, he can fire on Ahsoka.
Yeah,
I don't know if he realizes that.
Well, I don't know. We'll see. He was measuring for it last time.
Yeah.
So I believe he does know that's happening.
Where's the thug going? Straight. Well, that makes sense. He's doing a straight three.
And he's trying to stay in range for his TLT.
So what's he gonna do?
Well, straight four.
Oh, he's barrel rolling?
Yeah, straight four would have put as a red maneuver.
Yeah.
Which is freaking ridiculous, but...
Oh, so he probably barrel... Why did you think he barrel rolled? I think maybe... What is he doing?
He's trying to get Miranda out. I think what he was looking to do was try to get a shot on Morant, on the thug, but not have Dengar have a shot.
Oh.
Yeah.
But that's why the barrel roll happened, I guess. Did he just do a K-turn?
No. He just burned.
Yeah.
He's
in range of both.
That's just
but he,
bizarre.
Yeah, he's got... He,
it, the thug can't shoot on him.
Well, I thought Ahsoka's been shooting.
Oh.
Right?
No.
I thought she's been firing.
The last time she had... She was...
She took the damage from an asteroid, remember?
Yeah. Last time she would have really been able to fire, she was the only thing she could.
The other
she hit.
The one...
No, we did a one easy.
The one challenging part about Ahsoka, or Miranda, is if she's out of range, she doesn't get to regenerate a shield.
Yeah.
She's not like Cornhorn or...
If she's... Oh, yeah, because she has to be able to fight.
She's got to be able to take that dice off the attack.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So she's got to kind of stay at the edge of the fight if she needs to get her health back and try to minimize the amount of ships that can shoot on her.
Okay, so that was a green maneuver, so he took a target lock on
Ahsoka.
And he's probably going to kill it this turn.
And he might actually have range with the TLT.
Yeah,
he does. That's what he's measuring right now.
He's measuring Dengar right now.
I think. Yeah. That was Dengar. It's got to be outside of range one for the TLT.
Right, range two, he gets three dice. Bam, three hits.
Ooh, I think it's two hits and a crit.
Done.
And there goes Ahsoka.
Oh. Oh, that's not okay. Ahsoka did not get to do much useful work.
She got a...
Oh. Well, they both get to fire, though.
Yeah.
They're in range. TLT with a Miranda. That's... Oh, she's rolling one less dice.
So she'll...
then she should have only rolled one.
She rolled one on the first attack.
Oh.
No, she rolled two because you get three with TLT, right?
She doesn't have TLT.
Yes, she does. Just TLT. So she took only rolled two on the first
she rolled
one.
Rolled two,
and you can only regenerate the shield once, right?
Yep.
You can't use it on every attack.
No. But now she's back up to three health.
All right. So he's doing his TLT. Nothing.
No.
Two.
She's down to one hole.
Oh, jeez.
Now, what do you do if you're Miranda?
Run away. Well, there's nothing to do. But I still would have dropped some Connor net action.
Straight right off the board?
Yep.
Yeah. Can concede.
Two bank. I'd do a two bank. Or two hard. Probably do a two hard.
Yeah.
Okay. Woo, it's rare to see John C. lose. Wow.
He's outside his comfort zone. He really was.
Yeah.
Still. Okay, let's see. Shouldn't be too difficult. What do you think? Dengar has to do a hard left, I think. Right?
Yeah.
So to avoid the...
Well, that also puts him square face onto that stupid...
I'd do a bank. I'd do an easy.
Easy one bank?
I do a hard one to the left.
I'd do an easy easy.
That's
going
to line you up straight on with that, well...
Easy three.
You're very rarely
bottom.
Ever going to see a three out of Dengar.
Yeah.
But
unless
if
you're
gonna,
running an unhinged astromech.
But if I'm going to be have to go over that asteroid, basically no matter what...
Does Dengar...
Oh, hard two. Yeah, hard one of clear to asteroid.
I would not even bat an eyelash running over that
cluster mine at this point.
Yeah, if he went right, he'd
He should not clear it, but the problem is the Syndicate Thug is not in a great position right now.
Well, he's just going to have to do a hard turn.
He'll do a hard three.
Does he have... Yep. Hard three.
Yep.
Hard three to the left.
Yep.
To the left.
I'd seriously do a three bank to the left on Dengar. I'd run over that asteroid.
Do a hard two, one. To the left.
I'd still think you hit the asteroid.
It's a hard two? Wow.
Hard one will get clear. No doubt in my mind, hard one will clear that asteroid.
Okay.
Yeah, the Syndicate Thug's probably not going to get shot this turn.
Yeah. I don't think either one of them
are. It's a hard two. Yep. So hard on the dial for a K-Wing.
Yeah.
That's all they got.
All right. What is your action, Jackson? You're out of range three, so... Oh, okay,
Sweet
well.
Two.
He's slamming.
He's slamming for a two bank. He's trying to open up range. Why? I'm not 100% sure.
Let's see.
Unless he thinks he can slam... Okay. But he's up against 2/360, so we're going to get shots on him if he gets any...
Oh,
well,
he's decided the hell with it.
How would it close range do some damage?
Oh, wait. Did he actually run over it or not? Or did
he went
it?
Over it.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The movement template went over it.
Well, yeah.
Took nothing.
It put him in range, which is great.
Oh, yeah.
And Miranda's in his arc. Yeah, that's probably the right maneuver there.
His arc doesn't really matter.
Oh, it absolutely matters.
For
he'll get a second
shot. The shot back.
Nope. Miranda can't fire.
She can fire with the TLTs.
No,
right.
She
can't she
took
fire
weapons
at all.
Disable because
disabled.
Of slam.
Yeah, okay. That's
it.
All right. Well, round one.
Is done.
So does Steven stay on this table the next game?
I think he did.
All right. See you on the next game.